Today I am going to discuss about the microbial electrolysis cells for electromethanogenesis, materials, configurations, and operations. And this is the article that accumulated the informations about the mentioned topic. I would like to provide the informations under the following sections. Introduction. Principle of microbial electrolysis cells for methane production and different microbial pathways. The cathode and hydrogen evolution reaction. Electroactive bacteria and its extracellular electron transfer mechanism, microbial pathways used for methane production, materials used in constructing of microbial electrolysis cells, nanocatalysts for methane production, microbial electrolysis cell reactor configuration. Challenges and factors affecting microbial electrolysis cells performance, conclusions, and outlook. As we know, the entire world energy requirements have been powered by the use of non-renewable fossil fuels such as coal, natural gas, petroleum, and its products. Hence, there are two basic problems. Fossil fuels are exhaustible and are currently depleting at the most rapid rate due to their increasing applications and continual usage. Moreover, serious environmental threats and concerns are raised due to the emission of greenhouse gases into the atmosphere. Increased levels of carbon dioxide and other toxic gases get released due to the burning of fuels, which contribute to global warming. To overcome this alarming situation, carbon-free energy sources in a sustainable and environmentally friendly manner is needed, and microbial electrochemical systems prove to be an efficient way. Microbial electrochemical systems are classified into microbial fuel cells, microbial electrolysis cells, microbial desalination cells, and microbial solar cells based on the configuration of the reactor, environmental conditions, and products desired. Microbial electrolysis cells are the technology which is derived from microbial electrochemical systems, where the external voltage is applied to overcome the thermodynamic energy barrier to drive biochemical reactions. In this system, electromethanogenesis synthesizes methane in two ways, either by direct uptake of electrons from electrode called direct electromethanogenesis or indirect electromethanogenesis. This figure represents the schematics of a typical microbial electrolysis cells for electromethanogenesis. Here, in anode, oxidation reaction takes place, which is necessary to provide electrons for reduction of carbon dioxide in the biocathode region. Secondly, biocathode is the important component where methane is produced by the help of microorganisms using the electrons supplied from oxidation reaction taking place in anode. In this case, a separator or ion exchange membrane is necessary for migration of positively charged ions such as sodium, potassium or hydrogen ions from anodic chamber to cathodic chamber to keep the solution electroneutral. Lastly, externally provided electrical energy is needed to drive the reaction thermodynamically. Hydrogen is one of the striking alternative for fossil fuels in the approaching future. So, selection of appropriate cathode material is very important for the microbial electrolysis cells to produce hydrogen. Significant factors like production rate of hydrogen, the overall recovery of hydrogen, long-term durability, and Coulombic efficiency needs to contemplate when a cathode is being assessed. And to achieve high energy efficiency for the water splitting electrochemical reaction, use of specific catalyst is required for minimization of overpotential and enhancement of the hydrogen evolution reaction rate. Microbial electrolysis cells are those bioelectrochemical devices which transform the chemical form of energy stored in the feedstock to high value added chemicals such as hydrogen, methane, acetate, and many more. This biological conversion takes place using the metabolic activity of few microbial species which can produce electrons or reduce of carbon dioxide. These microorganisms are normally called electroactive bacteria. Two types of electron transfer take place, outside the membrane to inside and vice versa. Electrons and protons generated during anodic oxidation is utilized at the cathode side for carbon dioxide reduction directly or indirectly. The direct electromethanogenesis in the biocathode is carried out through redox external membrane proteins in the form of cytochromes that are in contact with the cathode. In addition to cytochrome, different outer membrane proteins like the ferredoxin, rhodopsin, hydrogenase, and /or formate dehydrogenase are involved in electron transfer. Exoelectrogenic species like methanocercina and methanocita, which reduces carbon dioxide to methane, can transfer electrons directly from elemental iron. And a greater portion of methane is developed through the carbon dioxide reduction pathway. Any product synthesized inside an organism is a result of a biochemical reaction or a pathway. This may involve many metabolic steps involving breaking, modifying, or building up of biochemical structures and compounds. Some end products of a metabolic process can be a reactant for another pathway. However, there are three metabolic routes of methane production: acetoclastic, methylotrophic, and hydrogenotrophic/carbon dioxide reduction pathway. Here, the figure represents three metabolic routes implemented by microbes for electromethanogenesis. Among them, carbon dioxide reduction pathway is believed to be the major driver of the methane biosynthesis. However, other pathways gain importance when working with mixed cultures. Carbon dioxide reduction pathway is around 4 times more widely observed than both methylotrophic and acetoclastic pathways combined. This is because carbon dioxide and hydrogen are readily available during hydrogenotrophic methanogenesis. The materials used to construct the microbial electrolysis cell system are the key to determine the performance of the system. Hence, optimization of the materials used in a microbial electrolysis cell is critical and needs to be considered earnestly for an efficient system. The components are anode, cathode, and membrane or separator. In anode, various carbon-based materials such as graphite fiber brush, graphite granules, graphite felt, carbon paper, carbon cloth, carbon fiber and vitreous carbon are used for the production of methane, which have the high electrical conductivity, chemical stability, anti-corrosiveness, good biocompatibility, low resistance, large surface area, strong mechanical strength, fouling resistance, and scalability, preferably with ease of construction and low cost. Cathode materials play pivotal role in electromethanogenesis as well as electrohydrogenesis. The electromethanogenesis is need less energy input compared to electrohydrogenesis. Hence, cathode material properties, its surface area, catalytic activity, biocompatibility play significant part in terms of microbial electrolysis cell performance output. The overall performance of the microbial electrolysis cells depends upon the electrodes and the materials from which they are developed. Because, with the help of direct electron transfer or hydrogen evolution, production of methane takes place by carbon dioxide reduction carried on both electrodes, anode and cathode. Beside these, membranes are the component of microbial electrolysis cells which is used to physically divide the cathode and anode into chambers. This separator is very important to design any two-chambered microbial electrolysis cells. Membranes prevent the mass diffusion of substrate, methane gas, hydrogen gas, and microorganisms between the anodic and cathodic chambers. Nanoparticles have a very high surface area to volume ratio. This increases the surface space available for both catalytic activity and microbial interaction. Many properties like surface conductivity, affinity, porosity, and roughness of the electrode materials can be altered with the addition of functional groups to the nanoparticles for improving cellular adherence. Like every other field where nanotechnology has helped to improve results in processes and applications, it has been instrumental in bioelectrochemical systems for energy production. The configuration of the chamber in microbial electrolysis cells plays a vital character in the selection of the process to produce methane. The microbial electrolysis cell reactor design directly influences the methane production, the energy efficiency of system and capital costs. Different reactor configurations have been propounded, which consists of single chamber and double chamber configurations. Various chamber configurations durations depend upon the presence or absence of ionic exchange membranes in the system, which usually tends to divide the system into single or two chambers. Single-chambered microbial electrolysis cells are developed by detaching membranes from the double-chambered systems. The anode and the cathode, therefore, remain in the same solution of the single chamber, which helps to minimizes both the ohmic voltage loss and pH gradient. This reduces the potential loss caused due to the membrane resistance. It also decreases the high capital cost and simplifies the design of the reactor. Due to this advantage, fabrication and sterilization become easy. Single chamber reactor is easy to fabricate and maintain because it does not involve membrane related complications like fouling and resistance. In addition to that, the single chamber MEC configuration encourages the multiplication of hydrogenotrophic methanogens, which produces methane by consumption of hydrogen. On the other hand, two-chamber configuration is the long-established type of microbial electrolysis cells in which the cathode and anode work individually in separate chambers which are usually divided by a membrane. In this configuration, cathode and anode are coupled by the external circuit, to which electrical energy is supplied using a power source. Various membranes have been used in two-chamber configuration microbial electrolysis cells, in which the most common membrane used is a proton exchange membrane constructed using functional groups which only allows free protons to pass from the membrane. There are some challenges and factors those may affect the performance of microbial electrolysis cells. The factors are applied potential, temperature, pH, substrate, and so on. As we know, the applied voltage or external voltage is one of the requisite physical parameters for the performance of the microbial electrolysis cells to manufacture methane. Adjustment in the applied voltage has a significant influence on the growth and distribution of electroactive bacteria and further impacts methane generation. Thus, there is a need to consider optimal external voltage, which should be specific for various substrates to achieve high rate production of methane. Then, temperature has a significant effect on the performance of microbial electrolysis cells. The varying temperature in the course of microbial electrolysis cell operation brings about the changes in microbial activity and community. This changes subsequently affects the performance of the reactor. Most of the electromethanogenesis studies have been carried under two ranges of temperature, one is in ambient temperature while others are in mesophilic conditions. The temperature change affects the growth and mass transfer rate of electroactive bacteria. Along with applied potential and temperature, pH2 affects the production of methane in microbial electrolysis cells. Most of the methane-producing microbial electrolysis cells operate at pH 7 due to the neutral behavior of microorganisms. This is because the electroactive bacteria is sensitive to its surrounding pH. Even the slight fluctuation in the pH would cause changes in the metabolism of microbes. Several other factors like ion transfer, substrate oxidation and solution conductivity too are associated with the change in pH directly or indirectly. Another factor is the substrate. Electroactive bacteria oxidizes the substrate and transfers the electrons to the cathode through the anode to produce methane. Choosing the appropriate substrate is necessary to determine the final yield of methane. Organic concentration and feeding rate of the substrate are the two parameters which have a crucial role in microbial electrolysis cells for high methane yield. Any organic substrate ranging from simple carbohydrates to complex fermentable substrates like wastewater and biomass can be employed in microbial electrolysis cells. The most commonly used substrate in microbial electrolysis cells is acetate, having higher Coulombic efficiency of 91%. Moreover, applied current density is underutilized in the process design of microbial electrolysis cell reactors, which can largely contribute to the methane production. Stacked microbial electrolysis cells can overcome the performance limit due to low cathode/anode ratio by increasing the current density. Therefore, focusing on the current density instead of volume trick parameters can boost methane production. Due to the increased global warming around the world, the development and implementation of new green technologies for the production of methane must be environmentally friendly and sustainable. The ability to produce methane in single stage, having the capacity to work at room temperature using low-cost inputs, makes it an excellent alternative for treating wastewater, which can yield methane as a significant value-added product. Minimizing the losses caused due to the electron transfer, research and development of novel configurations in anode, cathode, electrode and membrane architecture are needed to intensify the product yield. Thank you so much for hearing me. If you like my video, then press like button and subscribe the channel.